In this lecture, we are going to discuss about crystal field fitting of d orbitals in tetrahedral complexes. In previous lecture, we discussed about the crystal field fitting of d orbitals in octahedral complexes. In octahedral complexes, the number of ligands are 6. In octahedral complex, the number of ligands are 6, and in tetrahedral complex, the number of ligands are 4. So the tetrahedral complex can be represented as ML4, where 4 is the coordination number of the metal and 4 ligands are attached to the central metal. In octahedral complex, the coordination number is 6. 6 ligands are bonded to the metal. Now let us see how the orbitals are splitted. D orbitals are splitted in tetrahedral complexes where the 4 ligands are bonded to the metal. Now this is the tetrahedral geometry of the complex. Tetrahedral geometry of the complex. So in a cube, it has been represented. So you can see here, the metal is at the center of the cube, or it is at the center of the tetrahedron, and the 4 ligands are at the 4 corners of the tetrahedron. 4 ligands are at the 4 corners of the tetrahedron. Let us see here the axis x, y, and z. So in the tetrahedral complex, the ligands are approaches towards the central metal ion. The ligands are approaches towards the central metal ion, not through the axis. We know that in octahedral complex, the ligands are moving towards the central metal ion. The ligands are moving towards the central metal ion through the axis. But this diagram shows that the 4 ligands are at the 4 corners of the tetrahedron. The 4 ligands are at the 4 corners of the tetrahedron, and the metal is at the center of the cube. The position of the metal is at the center of the cube. This is shown in the figure. The metal is at the center and 4 ligands are placed at the 4 alternate corners. You can see here, 4 alternate corners of the cube. The 4 ligands are thus lying in between the axes. You can see here, the 4 ligands are lying in between the axes. That is x, y, and z axis, but are not directly facing any of the d orbitals. The ligands are not directly facing any of the d orbitals. So in this case, none of the d orbitals are lies in the direction of the ligands. So to understand this, let us represent the 5 d orbitals here in this diagram. So the metal d orbitals, 5 d orbitals of the metal. First one, it is that is dz square orbital, dz square orbital of the central metal. Then dx square minus y square orbital. So the lobes of the orbitals are lies along the axis, along the x and y axis. Dx square minus y square orbital. Similarly, dz square orbital lies along the axis. While remaining orbitals such as dxy, dyz and dxz, they are in between the axis. So let us represent these orbitals dxy, dyz and dxz. So suppose this is dyz orbital in between y and z axis. Now this is dxy orbital in between x and y axis. Similarly, we can show the dxz orbital in between x and z axis. So suppose this is dxz orbital. So this is the position of the metal d orbitals. So dz square orbitals are lies along the axis, and dx square minus y square orbitals are also lies along the axis. So it means that here dz square and dx square minus y square, these orbitals are also called as doubly degenerate orbitals, EG orbitals, and dxy, dyz and dxz orbitals, these three orbitals are called as T2G orbitals, triply degenerate orbitals. So the direction of the ligands toward the central metal ion here shows that no 1d orbitals are lies in the direction of the ligands. No orbitals are there, are lies in the direction of the ligands. See here, no 1d orbitals. This is the ligand. Okay, not dz square orbital or not dxy, dyz and dxz orbital. So does the splitting of the orbital is takes place in the tetrahedral complex? Yes, definitely it takes place. It means those orbitals which are nearer to the ligands, that orbitals are affected by the surrounding ligand field. In the assumption of the crystal field theory, we know that there is an interaction between the d orbitals of the central metal ion with surrounding ligand field. So in this case, as the ligands are approaches toward the central metal ion, so no 1d orbital is lies in the direction of the ligand, but there is an effect of the surrounding ligand field on the orbitals of the central metal ion. So how that effect is here in the tetrahedral complex? So if you see, the dxy, dyz and dxz orbitals are nearer to the ligands, while dz square and dx square minus y square orbitals are away from the ligand. You can see here the angle between dz square orbital, metal and this ligand. So this angle is greater here as compared to the angle between dyz ligand and metal. So the dxy, dyz and dxz orbitals are nearer to the ligands, close to the ligand, even though they are not lies, but they are nearer to the ligands. Hence, these orbitals are mostly affected by the surrounding ligand field, while the dz square and dx square minus y square orbital, that is EG orbital, are not, they are away from the ligand. So they are less affected by the surrounding ligand field. So in this way, those orbitals who are affected more by the surrounding ligand field, their energy will be increases. And those orbitals who are less affected by the surrounding ligand field, their energy becomes get down. So the five orbitals cannot remain degenerate. These five d orbitals are splitted into the two group. So let us show that diagram how the splitting of the orbital is takes place. So you can see here, this is the splitting energy diagram for the tetrahedral complex. So we can see here in this diagram the 5d orbitals which are degenerate orbitals in absence of the ligand field, but in presence of the ligand field these 5d orbitals are splitted, that is t2g plus eg. T2g means triply degenerate and eg means doubly degenerate. So this 5d orbitals now splitted in presence of the surrounding ligand field in the tetrahedral complex. Now in the tetrahedral complex, as T2g orbitals are nearer to the ligand, we have shown here T2g orbitals are nearer to the ligand, this dxy dyz and dxz. So they are affected by the ligand field more as compared to the dz square and dx square minus y square orbital. So T2g orbitals are affected by the surrounding ligand field more, hence their energy will be increases. These orbitals are electrostatically less comfortable with the surrounding ligand field, hence their energy will be increases. So the energy of the T2g orbital, but now in case of the tetrahedral complex we can use the symbol T2, because in tetrahedral complex there is no center of the symmetry, so we cannot use here this T2g, it is only T2, triply degenerate. T2g means triply degenerate geared orbitals. So as the orbitals are not having the center of the symmetry, so this symbol, it is only now T2 orbital in the tetrahedral complex. So the energy of the T2 orbital, it is increases by 0.4 delta T. What is delta T here? Delta T, it is the splitting energy. Delta T, it is the energy gap between the T2 orbital and E orbital. So there is a decrease in the energy level of the E orbital, that is dx square minus y square and dz square. So how much decrease is there? That decrease should be equal to 0.6. Negative sign indicates that the energy will be decreases. Minus sign indicates that the energy of the orbitals will be decreases. Or to maintain this average energy constant, the energy of the T2 orbitals will be increases by, the energy of the T2 orbital will be increases by 4 dq unit or 0.4 delta T, and the energy of E orbital will be decreases by 6 dq unit. And this delta T, it is the difference between the T2 orbital and E orbital. So in the tetrahedral complex, we can use the symbol here T2 and E. E stands for doubly degenerate and T2 stands for triply degenerate. So in this way, in the tetrahedral complex, in the tetrahedral complexes, the crystal field splitting of the D orbital will be takes place. It is totally opposite to that of the octahedral complex. In octahedral complex, the energy of the T2g orbital will be decreases and energy of the Eg orbital will be increases. But now in case of the tetrahedral complex, as no one ligands are lies in the direction of the no one d orbitals are lies in the direction of the ligands, hence the orbitals which are nearer to the ligands, that orbitals are T2 orbitals, dxy dyz and dxz. So there is a rise in the energy level of these orbitals by 0.4 delta T or 4 dq, and there is a decrease in the energy of level of the E orbital. Hence the crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complexes, it is opposite to that of the octahedral complexes. You can see this diagram here. This diagram shows the crystal field splitting of tetrahedral and octahedral complex. So you can see here in octahedral complex, the energy of the Eg orbital is increases and the energy of the T2g orbital is decreases. and in the tetrahedral complex, the energy of the t2 orbitals will be increases and energy of the e orbital will be decreases. So totally opposite here. And also the crystal field splitting will be less here. This energy gap between the t2 orbital and e orbital will be less. In the octahedral complex, it will be larger. The degree of the crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complexes will be less. This is because there are only 4 ligands in the tetrahedral complex. In the tetrahedral complex, there are only 4 ligands are surrounded to the metal. That is ML4 in the tetrahedral complex. 4 ligands are there. And in the octahedral complex, there are 6 ligands. So 6 ligands will create more ligand field effect onto the orbitals of the central metal ion. So orbitals are splitted too much. So this energy gap will be larger here. Okay. So in this way, the crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complexes will be takes place. It is totally opposite to that of the octahedral complex, or it is inverse to that of the octahedral complex. So once again, you can see the crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complex, the energy of the T2 orbital will be increases here because there are nearer to the ligand, and energy of the E orbital will be decreases to some extent. So they are because these orbitals are somewhat away from the ligands. So effect of the ligand field will be more onto the T2 orbital as compared to the E orbital. Hence, there is an increase in the energy level of the T2 orbital. So this diagram shows us the direction of the ligands towards the metal orbitals. So actually no one metal d orbitals are lies in the direction of the ligands, but dxy, dyz and dxz, these orbitals are nearer to the ligand. Hence, they are affected by the surrounding ligand field more as compared to the eg orbital. Therefore, the energy of t2 orbital will be increases here and the energy of the e orbital will be decreases. Now, in this case, we can say that delta t, it is equal to -4/9 delta o. Delta t, that is crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complex, it is 4/9 to that of the octahedral complex. Okay. So in this way, in this lecture, we have discussed the crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complexes. The 5d orbitals are splitted into the two energy state, into the two groups. One group, it is T2 group, which has the higher energy level. And other group is the E group, that is doubly degenerate orbital, which is having the lower energy level. So in this way, crystal field splitting in the tetrahedral complexes takes place.